Hi, my name's Ashley, and in 2017 I went for a walk, a 2,800-mile walk across Western Europe, from baking hot Spain to the icy mountain passes of the Alps. This is my adventure.
I just want to reiterate how stupid it was to come up here.
This is the first stage of my walk across Europe, and it's the GR7. This is a 1,179-mile footpath that goes right across Spain, from Tarifa in the south up to Andorra in the north. I'm starting out in Tarifa. It's a very windy town on the southernmost tip of Spain and of Europe as a whole. As the ferry sets sail for Tangiers, I leave the Mediterranean behind for Andorra.
Day one, I've just left Tarifa, walking along the beach. That way is a bit of water in Africa. That way is just all Spain. 2 months of Spain.
Today the future feels like memories. I want a past that can go that far. Today my accidents are remedies, 'cause my karma can go that far. The world was supposed to make my fantasies. I'm still playing the playing game. Across the plains of Africa, I want to feel I can go that far. Today my actions feel like melodies. I wanted to.
The days were long and they were hot. I was beginning to question some of my recent life choices. And my chosen method of transport.
Fantastic view this, I can see right down to Yamina de la Frontera, where I set out from this morning, and then on the horizon, standing out like a sore thumb, is the Rock of Gibraltar, where I was a week ago. So it's fantastic to just see the distance that I've covered in one view. Amazing. Just come down this steep path. I've got to the bottom here, a bit of a dead end, and I checked the GPS, and apparently I'm way off. I should be on the other side of this thing here. I have no idea where the path is because I saw no markers and no other obvious path. I'm just going to have to backtrack up until the GPS says I'm on the trail and then see if I can see where it goes. I think this is my problem. Instead of going up that open gate up the hillside, I should have gone through that closed gate down the hillside. I'm guessing that road probably swings round the side of the hill and then back up again. That's what we're going to take from what the GPS was saying before. I'll give it a punt, see what happens. Believe this, just about 20 metres from the gate, it's GR waymark, made it, unmistakable. So I've just made it down the pass. I came down just up there, behind the trees. And I'm in this really lovely, another really lovely wide open valley.
The first large town on my route would be the cliff-top Ronda. The new and the old towns are divided by a deep gorge, but linked by the beautiful Puente Nuevo, or New Bridge.
The problem with these tracks is they're great when they're dry, but when they're wet they just turn into a mud bath. It's just really hard to get anywhere with your boots caked in mud.
What do you feel? What do you feel when you look in my eyes, staying like light? What do you need to know my journey?
This looks like a really nice walk around a reservoir, and I thought, oh great, I'll sit there, I'll eat my crisps and I'll have a nice little view. In reality, this is the reservoir. Thank you.
took my shoes off and I've got a massive blister on my heel. Swelled up enormous. I think I'm going to have to do something with it. I'm not quite sure what. I don't know. I think I'm going to have to drain it. Otherwise it'll just pop when I'm walking and it'll be agony. I don't know if it's the right thing to do, I'm not sure. Oh, I've got to do something. This is really not the advised way to drain a blister. I was entering the Spanish Sierra Nevada. The peaks around were still dusted in snow, and I knew that in just a couple more days I'd be crossing the mountains at 2,000 metres. Snow really was the last thing I wanted to see. So tomorrow's plan is an early start. We're here at La Rolls, and we've got to cross Sierra Nevada at the Puerto de la Ragua to La Calahora. Looks really simple on this large scale map, but it involves an ascent of 1400 metres and then a descent of nearly 1000 on the other side, and it's also a 20 mile walk. So I'm going to try and get up really early and then see how far I can get.
So it's like 9 a.m. It's a bit later than I intended to start. I just couldn't sleep last night, so I just changed the alarm from 6 to 7, and then just, you know, was just lazy, basically. So I'm climbing out of La Rolls now. I'm unlikely to make La Calahora before dark, so I'll just have to find a place to pitch and hope it's not too cold. The sky's quite dramatic today, but it looks clearish over, well, from what I can see towards the pass, so hopefully it won't be too bad. I made it at Puerto de la Regia, 2,000 metres on the pass. As you see, it's very snowy, but I've made it. It's 5:30, so that's taken me 8.5 hours. So I'm not going to make La Calahora before midnight, before dark even. So I'll just descend as much as I can, find a place to camp, hopefully where it's a bit warmer. And there's no snow. Let's go. Go inside the castle, but it's only open on Wednesday and today's Friday, so looks like it's back on the road.
The north face of the Sierra Nevada. The day after my crossing, a fresh snowstorm blanketed the mountains. I was lucky to have made it over on the day I did.
I ask her why she's smiling at me. She says just because she's happy, and I can relate, oh, I can relate, she's my relief. falling asleep, still holding my hand, and I'm falling hard, but she's a soft place to land. Sirens and storms, oh, the world is reborn, spinning for her. Welcome it in, but she's still asleep, so I kiss her again. With her by my side, oh, with her in my life, I'm happy I'm me.
Doing mister, oh no, think you're gonna miss her, don't show too many feelings, they will come out when the time is right. I said candles can be dangerous, and she agreed with a smile. And the dusk it settled silently around us into a peaceful night. My heart knew none of that peace, and I lay there for quite some time. Sleep, it was a sweet release, and the rain came down from the sky. Hi, hi, oh, hey, ho, how you doing, mister? Oh, no, think you're gonna miss her, don't show. Feelings, they will come out when the time is. Hey, ho, how you doing, mister? Oh, no, think you're gonna miss her, don't show. Too many feelings.
Walking in Spain, starter pack. One, neckerchief, to keep the sun off the neck. I'd like to tuck it into my shirt, but it never stays in. Two, sunglasses. Yeah. Three, a hat with a cape. Now, this hat is called the Kalahari, so I know it makes me look like a badass. But more importantly, it stops the old ears getting burnt.
Hey. Mister, oh no, you're gonna miss her, don't show. Too many feelings, they will come out when the time is. Hey, ho, how you doing, mister? Oh no, think you're gonna miss her, don't
ready
show.
Take on any trail, any time.
They will come out when the time is right. 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 When the time is right, when the time is right, when the time is right, when the time is right.
I'd run out of cooking gas, and the only place I could get any was Murcia City, which was a bit of a detour. But when I was there, I found myself a front row seat to the Holy Week parade. Seen anything like that before, any parade like that before. So yeah, it was well worth the outing. Spent the better part of yesterday afternoon and then this morning climbing up into this pass, and I've come up against this huge fence. It looks like something out of Jurassic Park. If I go down the tunnel, and there's a gate on the end which I could get through if I wanted. It's a sign that it's in Spanish. But Google Translate seems to indicate, it says don't go through here, danger of parasites, tuberculosis, scabies, disinfect yourself before entering and when leaving the area. So annoying because the path is just right there, and looking at the map, I'm not entirely sure there's a way to get around this valley. So I don't know quite what to do. I don't think I want to risk going through this and contracting something dodgy or passing something onto the outside world. I might have to go down. Oh, what a pain in the arse. So I've just come back down from the pass. I'm pretty much on this spot where I camped last night, next to the ruined farmhouse and overlooking these hills. I've had a look at the map, and there should be a path or a trail or a track that goes down the bottom of this valley and then connects to the road at the end. And I might be able to use a track that comes off that road to reach the valley I was at. So I'm just trying to dodge a bee. I've just been stung by a bee. I don't want to get stung again. I should be able to get around this pass from the valley floor. Hopefully that's not sealed off down there as well. It could still turn out to be a very long day. Pass that I couldn't get over, right up there between those crags, those hills. This road's been a pain so far. There's a river running right beside it, and it crosses the river a lot, and the road itself has been flooded at least twice. I had to bushwhack a couple of times. The second time was horrible. I had to crawl under bramble bushes and then pull my pack along beside me, and I'd like then run along the road and scout and see if it was passable. God knows what it's going to be like after. I've got another bit to cross now right here. Hopefully I'll do that without getting my feet any wetter. Bit of an adventure today. I was really hoping to make a shop tomorrow, but with all this detouring, I might be cutting it fine, so I'm gonna have to ration my food. Oh, what a day. It's about a bit of a rough day today, really. Well, there was that the problem along that pass, so I had to descend back down to the valley floor and fight my way along it, only to then turn back because the linking gate on the river wouldn't open. And then we had that road walk and then a overgrown, loads of stream crossings. I had to ford a river, which wasn't the best thing to do, really. But then I've just got up here, and I found this refuge. So come on inside. So here we are. There's a table. Got my tent ground sheet. I've got that laid out on the floor, and then the sleeping mat and sleeping bag on top of that. So that's my bed for the night. The best thing is
only had a litre of water left, and I thought, well, I'll have half tonight. Usually I have half a litre at night with my tea, and then I've only got half a litre for a walk down. There's no tap here, but it's a load of water. So hopefully it's drinkable, because I filled up one of my bottles, and I'll use that tomorrow. So yeah, pretty chuffed about this. Yeah, cool.
Favourite town in Spain? Morella. The modern town still surrounded by its complete medieval walls. It was a place I loved exploring. South face of the Pyrenees. It appeared on the horizon yesterday morning when I got up, and I spent all day yesterday and then the first part of the day walking towards them, and I start climbing up into them this afternoon or tomorrow morning perhaps. It's Tuesday. My nephew Owen, it's his, he turns 3 on Saturday, so I'm hoping I can make Andorra on Friday. I'm going to have a little bit of a video call with the family, say happy birthday to the little man.
Thank you.
Andorra La Vella, the highest capital city in Europe. Yeah, it's because you're an hour behind me, isn't it? Damn. I learnt a lot on my journey across Spain, but my biggest lesson was that the bad times can, and do, very quickly swing to good, and vice versa. In short, you've got to take the rough with the smooth. That's what makes the good times good. Having been on the road for 3 months, it felt like a bit of an end. But really, it was just the beginning. And next, I would have to find my way out of the Pyrenees, across France, to the Alps.